Now we'll come to the second project, which is enhancement of the OpenIDEX analytics. This OpenIDEX analytics has got four components. One is that pipeline, another is analytics API, another third is the analytics dashboard, and fourth is the that learning management system or content management system. Now this analytics pipeline is actually, it is installed in their case in the Amazon cloud, that is Elastic MapReduce, which has got its own Hadoop cluster in it, and they have used the MapReduce tasks for for processing the log files, and they are using a Luigi, which is a workflow management software. So and it basically runs the Hadoop MapReduce tasks. And this, after they process the data, they keep it in the MySQL database or in the Elasticsearch documents. These two places they keep. Then the next component is the data analytics API. So the data which is created by the pipeline tasks are not directly available. You have to use the API and some authentication mechanism to get the data. Okay, so these are all written on the REST framework. And you can send the request with some token, and then you can get the data. So third component is the analytics dashboard, which is a visual component. So this is it basically calls that data API to get the data, and then it shows it on the dashboard. And it uses mostly Node.js, npm, Bower, jQuery, Backbone, all those technologies. Now this currently they have got four modules: enrollment, engagement, then the performance and learners. So we'll be changing this for one or two of these components. Okay. Now daily activity enrollment it shows that all the that is day wise enrollment, derollment, education, age, gender, etc. We are not, we'll not be changing this one. Then engagement they have got two. One is the engagement to the content, that is the course content, and there is the engagement to the video. So we'll be changing one of this, that is engagement to the video. Okay. Then next is the performance. Performance also will be changing because we have to show the, we'll explain the FTP, that features, then you'll understand it better. Then that learners in module, it shows the activity in past 1 week, that is how many problems they have attended, how many videos they have viewed, what are the forums they have attended. Okay, now the faculty development program, they have got these features. One is called learning dialogue, another is learning by doing, learning experience interaction, and learning extension trajectory. Learning dialogue is in between the videos, they have put some pause, which they call reflection points. So, and they had given some quizzes at those points. So, the person, if the person answers it or the ignores it, then we can see and what is his performance. So, in learning by doing, they have got some quizzes which are related to those pauses. So if we will be seeing that how the performance is on this LBD, that is on these quizzes, and whether he has seen the video before attempting this one, and what is the common interaction between these two parts, watching the video and his performance. Okay. And third is the learning experience interaction, that is the forum participation. That is how many people have participated in the forum. And what is the, after participation of the forums, how is the performance affected if they have participated. Then fourth is the learning extension trajectory. So these are the different, this course has offered different kinds of resources like PDF or text files or HTML content. So they want to know which is mostly accessed. That is, people are preferring which kind of resources, and if they are access more than one resources, then what is the pattern of accessing? So this kind of analysis they want to do. Okay, so we'll be incorporating these things in the OpenIDEX dashboard. So this is the that what I told you just now. So implementation plan may you have to write the MapReduce task on the Hadoop cluster, and the output will be on the MySQL database. You have to write the REST framework based API to access the outputs of the pipeline tasks, that is the MapReduce tasks. And you have to implement the visualization of the OpenEdX dashboard. And you have to follow the same framework which OpenEdX has used. Thank you.